Hi everyone, welcome back. This is Dr. Nisha Garg. In today's video, we'll be discussing the basic dental terminology. This video will be useful to all, whether a dental student, hygienist, patient, or anybody who wants to have the knowledge about teeth. So let's start. First of all, let's see the jaws which hold the teeth. The teeth are present in the jaws, and there are two jaws, the upper or the maxillary jaw and the lower, which is also known as the mandibular jaw. The teeth present in the upper jaw or the maxillary jaw are called maxillary teeth, and teeth which are present in the mandibular jaw, they are called the mandibular teeth. The term dentulous means the natural teeth present in a jaw, and the term edentulous means the missing teeth in a jaw. When all teeth are missing, it is called completely edentulous, and when only few teeth are missing, it is known as partially edentulous arch. Primary dentition is also known as primary teeth, milk teeth, baby teeth, or deciduous teeth. There are total 20 teeth in primary dentition, 10 in the upper and 10 in the lower arch. Now let's see the different teeth present in primary dentition. See, there are 4 incisors per arch, 2 canines per arch, and 4 molars per arch. This makes total of 10 teeth in the upper arch and 10 in the lower arch. Please note there are no premolars in the primary dentition. These primary teeth or the baby teeth, they start coming in the mouth at around 6 months of age. And teeth coming in the mouth is called eruption of teeth. And all the baby teeth, they should fall by the age of 12. And falling of baby teeth is called exfoliation. Side by side, adult teeth or permanent teeth, also known as permanent dentition, they start erupting. So these teeth, that is the permanent teeth, they start erupting at the age of 6 years and they never exfoliate as long as the teeth remain healthy. We have 32 teeth in the permanent dentition, and if we look at the number of teeth per arch, there are 4 incisors per arch, 2 canines per arch, 4 premolars and 6 molars per arch. This makes 16 teeth per arch. That means 16 teeth in the maxillary arch and 16 in the mandibular arch. See, these upper and the lower arches are also divided into halves, making 4 quadrants of total teeth set. That is upper right quadrant, upper left quadrant, lower left quadrant and lower right quadrant. Now we'll see how to number these teeth present in the mouth. See, there are many tooth numbering systems, but mainly 3 types of tooth numbering systems are commonly used by dental professionals depending upon where you live. These systems are universal system, Zsigmondy-Palmer system and FDI system of tooth numbering. So let's start with the universal system of tooth numbering. The universal system is just like reading numbers. You start with the top right quadrant, that is from here, and then you go from right to left. Please note that it is patient's right to left. When you're looking at the patient's mouth, the patient's right side is your left side. So don't get confused here. It is patient's right to left. So in universal system, if we start from this side, this is tooth number 1. And which tooth is this? Yes, upper right 3rd molar. And then from here, we write 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. And we go till here. And this is the last tooth of upper arch. This is tooth number 16 and Which tooth is this? Yes, upper left third molar. Now from here, come to the lower arch. Continue the cycle. So this is tooth number 17. That is, yes, lower left third molar. And this is tooth number 18, 19, 20, and so on, all the way round till the tooth number 32, which is the lower right third molar. So it's just a counting from 1 to 32. And if we revise it, for example, upper right third molar is tooth number 1. Which tooth number is upper right central incisor? As we can see, it is tooth number 8. And left central incisor is 9. And first molar on the left side is, yes, this is number 14. Lower left first molar is tooth number 19. So we can see that every tooth is given a unique number in the universal system. For the palm annotation, we break the mouth in four quadrants like this. Since each quadrant has 8 teeth, we start from the midline and go till the last tooth of that quadrant. So we can say that the central incisor is number 1, lateral incisor is tooth number 2, canine will be number 3, first premolar will be number 4, second premolar will be tooth number 5, first molar will be number 6, second molar will be number 7, and third molar will be number 8. And this is same for all the quadrants like this. See, now the question is how to differentiate between the teeth among all different quadrants. See, notice this. If we look at this shape, see, this is quadrant. See, this quadrant is backward L, this one is L, and this side is upside L, and this quadrant is denoted by upside down backward L. So we can say that a unique symbol is given to each quadrant. Now to know the tooth, just use the sign of that quadrant and just put the number of tooth we want to talk about in that symbol. For example, if we want to number the right maxillary first molar, it will be like this. And if it's left maxillary first molar, then we'll write like this. Similarly, left mandibular canine is like this and right mandibular second premolar is like this. See, though this system is simple and easy to use, but it's difficult to communicate by using this system. Now, lastly is the FDI system of tooth numbering. See, this system uses two-digit system where the first digit tells about the quadrant we are talking about. And the second digit is same as that of the palm annotation. Like one is the central incisor, two is lateral incisor, and so on. Eight is the third molar. And if we look at the numbers of quadrants, number one is the right maxillary quadrant, two is the left maxillary quadrant, three is left mandibular, and four is right mandibular quadrant. And when we combine these two digits, that is quadrant and the tooth, these two digits, they should be pronounced separately in communication. For example, if you're talking about lower left permanent second molar, it is, you can see this is a third quadrant and tooth number 7 is the second molar, so this will be 3-7. And similarly, if we look at this, the upper right canine, this means upper right. This is the first quadrant and canine is the number 3 tooth. So it is 1-3. And upper left canine will be 3 is canine. And for upper left, it is quadrant number 2. So this is 2-3. So in FTA system, you can see there is no confusion and it is simple to learn and understand. Now let's see how to number the baby teeth or primary teeth. See, you have seen the three numbering systems for permanent dentition. And there are only slight modifications of these systems for numbering of the primary teeth. For example, in case of universal system, instead of number 1 to 20, since there are 20 teeth, we denote each tooth by a capital letter from A to T. For this, we start from the right maxillary second molar, which is letter A. Then we go to the first molar, which will be letter B. Similarly, C, T, E. And on the left side of central incisor, we'll be giving as F, G, continuing to the upper left, which is letter J. And then downwards, K, L, M, N, and continuing to the letter T, which is extreme lower right, that is right mandibular second molar. And similarly, in the Palmer notation, where we give number 1 to 8 for each tooth in the permanent dentition, in case of primary, here we assign the letters A to E for each tooth following the same pattern. But here the only difference is that instead of numbers, we are giving letters to the each tooth. And we are using exactly the same quadrant symbol which we used for the permanent dentition. For example, this is upper right second molar. This is upper right canine. This is upper left lateral incisor. This is upper left second molar. This is lower left canine. This is lower right first molar. And if you look at the FDA system, as you know, we use two digits, where the first digit denotes the quadrant and second digit denotes the tooth number. So if you look at the quadrants, we use number 5, 6, 7, 8 for primary teeth instead of quadrant number 1, 2, 3, 4, which we used for permanent dentition. And the second digit goes from 1 to 5 as we saw in the permanent dentition. I hope this video is clear to you. In the second part of this video, we'll be discussing the surfaces, elevations, and depressions present on the teeth. Stay connected. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching. Take care and goodbye.